Well, what you are looking at might initially appear to just be a nice nine-hole golf course with a central lake. It is, in fact, much more than that from a geologic sense. As, if we zoom out, you can see that the entire property forms a bowl-shaped depression in the ground, which, in fact, marks a singular 2,730-foot or 832-meter-wide volcanic crater in the ground known as a maar. This feature marks one of the youngest vents in a little-known volcanic field. While the exact age of the aforementioned little borax lake maar in question is uncertain, one suggestion is that it may have formed approximately 13,000 years ago in the year 11,170 BCE. Yet, as we continue to look around, you might notice several bays on the shoreline which also have a highly circular profile, with the most prominent of these being known as Horseshoe Bay. These features mark 11 maars, which each were the site of a highly explosive volcanic eruption in the last 40,000 years. In fact, at least one of these eruptions were witnessed by indigenous peoples who lived in the area during the last 15,000 years, with oral tales passed down from generation to generation telling of large explosions, the raining down of numerous large boulders of rock, and the simultaneous noise of thunder. All of these maars, cinder cones, and much more encompass a broad 300-square-mile volcanic field known as the Clear Lake Volcanic Field. While this volcanic field has not produced an eruption since the year 7080 BCE, it had erupted at an average rate of once every 1800 years between 60,000 and 10,000 years ago, and will almost certainly erupt again one day. It should thus not come as a surprise that the most productive geothermal field on the planet exists here, being powered by the heat from a massive, stationary, and cooling 1.1 million-year-old body of magma, which has a volume of 300 cubic kilometers, which at its shallowest is at 6.5 kilometers or 4 miles below sea level. But do not worry, that body of magma can't erupt and in fact is used to power numerous geothermal power plants, generating enough electricity to power 725,000 homes. Actual future eruptions in the Clear Lake volcanic field will almost certainly occur in a small area surrounding Clear Lake or in Clear Lake itself, most likely forming a maar and generating pyroclastic flows or through the formation of a cinder cone. The aforementioned pyroclastic flows and thick ashfall can theoretically reach areas up to 5 kilometers away from event, and to show the dangers this could pose, I have overlaid actual young pyroclastic deposits from a linked scientific paper now being referenced, presumably with all of this being in place during the last 40,000 years. While none of these maar vents are likely to ever erupt again, there is always a chance for another one to pop up somewhat close by to an existing vent in the distant future, placing nearby communities at risk. It is for this reason that the Clear Lake volcanic field is classified as a high-threat volcano. But why does this volcanic complex exist in the first place? The first thing I want to note is that the Clear Lake complex is merely the youngest of a chain of slowly northward trending volcanic fields, the others of which are long extinct. Per a direct quote, these fields were erupted as passage of the Mendocino Triple Junction and lengthening of the San Andreas Fault opened magma pathways to the surface. As the nexus of subduction and transform movement marched northward, the age of each volcanic center approximately tracked the position of the triple junction and associated slab window at the time. The Clear Lake complex has also thus trended northwards over time during its 2.1 million-year-long lifespan, almost entirely creating scattered vents which erupt once and then never erupt again, but occasionally producing larger polygenetic vents which erupt multiple times. While the early eruptions largely produced basaltic cinder cones, more viscous magma would on occasion erupt as the overall field got older and older, sometimes even including rhyolite lavas. Polygenetic centers largely constructed lava dome complexes via overlapping layers of viscous lava, constructing Cobb Mountain, Mount Hanna, and most recently Mount Konocti. These centers each produce multiple explosive eruptions, although none of them are likely to ever individually erupt again, with the last such eruption from Konocti proper and not the vents surrounding it occurring 350,000 years ago. The most recent cluster of activity in the Clear Lake volcanic field involves six more forming eruptions between 11,300 BCE and 7,080 BCE, with 7,080 BCE marking the date of this field's last eruption. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Marina Grubisa, for supporting this channel.